Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Alicia B, and I am back with another video for you guys today. I did post up a video or a reel on my Instagram showing you how I take my notes for this class, and you absolutely loved it. You wanted me to show you how I do it. So if you're interested in my notes and want to see how I gain an A and A plus in this class, this is the video for you. And if you have not subscribed yet, make sure you hit that subscription button down below and the post notification bell and the thumbs up. That way I notify that you like this video and you guys are notified that I post another hit video as well. So without further ado, you guys, let's get right into this video. So the first thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you are in a good environment. When you are studying for anatomy and physiology, you have to make sure that you are in the environment that helps you study to the best of your ability. For me, that environment is some place that is very quiet, that is clean, that's clear of all the clutters, and has minimum to no distractions. So that is the very first step I get into when I prepare to study for anatomy and physiology. So the second step that I take when I'm getting ready to study for anatomy and physiology is put some peaceful music on. I either listen to jazz, classical, or lo-fi study music, and that really helps me in focusing on what I am studying. I make sure that the music that I'm listening to has no lyrics, that way the lyrics from the music doesn't distract me from what I am reading. I do have my Spotify playlist down in the description box below, so if you're interested to see what I am studying with, make sure you guys click that link down below as well. Usually people don't study with music, but I'm the type of person that has to, because if I have no music and it's really, really quiet, my brain tends to wander around a lot. So I find when I have that music, it helps my brain stay focused, and I'm focused more on what I'm reading and what I'm studying. The next very important step that I take is putting my phone, my tablet, and my computer in do not disturb mode. I make sure that this bad boy is not ringing, because once it is ringing, my brain is going to be distracted from what I'm studying, and that is something that I do not want to happen. I make sure that it is not in the way of me studying for anatomy and physiology. So after my environment is all set up, my music is on, my phone's on D&D mode, and the environment is clean and clear, the next thing I like to do is put up a timer on my laptop. So basically what I do is I just go on Google, type in online timer, and set it up on my laptop in a full screen mode. I usually do 45 minutes on, 10 minutes off, because that provides me the best results. And you can do whatever time works for you. I do not recommend studying as much as you can, because this course is not a study as much as you can type of course. It is a study, rest type of thing that we need to do. Our brain needs rest. Our brain needs time to rejuvenate and refresh. And this course definitely challenges you, but you need to remember to take your rest. One thing about this class is you will not memorize all the bones in one day. You will not memorize all the nerves in one day. You will not memorize all the muscles in one day. This takes time. So remember, rest is probably the most important thing for you while taking this class, because there is an extensive amount of information to take in, and we need to gain that rest. So I am stressing it because it is very important. A lot of students don't take rest when taking this course because they are very, very stressed. But rest is probably the best thing that you could do for yourself in order to pass this course. So once all that is figured out, we get into my favorite part in taking anatomy and physiology notes, and this is your color palette. Yes, I use a color palette. So what this does is it just literally makes my notes come to life. It doesn't make it so boring and so bland, because the brain likes color. So that is one thing that I realized. Before, I was not doing my notes in color, and I found that I was making my notes verbatim and it was not sticking, and it was just boring and not excited at all. So what I like to do is I like to pick a color palette, and I have two main core colors that never change no matter what, and those colors are red. Red is definitely my definitions color, and orange is my tips and tricks color. I also forgot to mention blue. I use blue for any examples that may be given in the text. So the only time I change colors is if I'm going to a new chapter and I'm learning a new subject, and that's when I change my color palette, but those two colors stay the same. Next thing I do now is I make sure that I know what exactly I'm studying. So what I like to do is I like to go on my school website, and depending on what chapter I'm on, I look at the objectives. The objectives will literally tell you what you are studying in this chapter. Key note, in nursing school, the objectives are usually what the teacher tests you on. So once you understand the objectives, you understand what the test is going to be on, and you are more likely to pass that class. What I like to do for anatomy and physiology is write down the objectives in like a question format. So that way, whenever I am done reading that chapter, I just answer the objective questions. And if I'm able to answer it in full, then I know that I've understood the context. If I have not been able to answer it in full, then I go back and I see what I've missed. But knowing exactly what you're studying by reading the objectives is key into knowing how to pass this class. So once I have my objectives written down, I go right into studying the book. So what I like to do is I have downloaded my textbook into my Books app because they did give us an e-text. So what I did was I downloaded that e-text book into my Books app that comes on my iPad. And that way I'm able to write down notes on the side, I'm able to underline, I'm able to highlight, and I'm also able to put in red and orange things that I need to know. So like I said before, red means definitions and orange means tips and tricks. So those two colors never change. So on my Books app, I make sure that anything that is a need to know or definition always goes in red. And anything that is tricky to know, I put it in orange. That way I can figure out some way or some tip and trick or some mnemonic, something to help me memorize it. So by doing this, I find that it helps a lot because it really helps me understand what I am reading and putting things in my own words as well. So when you are reading obviously by verbatim, like you're reading information, but when you're getting ready to transcribe those words from the book into your notes, you want to make sure that you are doing it in your own words. You're not doing it verbatim, because if you do it in your own words, you are showing yourself that you are understanding what you are reading. But if you do it just for verbatim, you are just writing word for word and you're not really taking in what you're writing, because it's just a what I see is what I write type of note taking. And that's something that we don't and that's something that we don't want to do in anatomy and physiology. So with that being said, this is probably my second favorite thing to do while doing anatomy and physiology, and it's taking notes. The reason why I like taking notes so much is because now what I am reading, I am putting it in my own words, in my own style, in the way that I find best to memorize and to know what I am reading. So the way I take my notes in anatomy and physiology, and actually in all my classes, is the outline method. So the outline method is you have a headline, and then underneath that headline you have the first point. So when you have the first point and you want to extend or you want to elaborate on that first point, you have a sub point or a subtitle for that point. So it'll be like point one, the brain has four chambers. And then 1A will be, these four chambers are, and then 1A will consist of the four chambers. It'll be the left ventricle, the right atrium, the left atrium. Things like that. So that way it keeps everything compounded and in that section. So that way everything's organized. I don't have to keep on looking back and forth to find that information. So I am a very visual learner. So anything that has charts, drawings, videos, anything that is cartoons, they are my friend, okay? So one thing that I love to do in my notes is draw. I think personally everybody will benefit from drawing in anatomy and physiology because you are literally learning your body, right? So once you draw and you understand what you are drawing, you kind of have more of an understanding of what you are reading as well. So with me, drawing makes me make more connections. And when you have more connections, you have a better understanding. And when you have a better understanding, there's no need to memorize because you already know what's happening. Does that make any sense? So for me, it's always understanding above memorization. Always. So after all of your note taking is done, the next thing I like to do is use outside sources. The outside sources are amazing, you guys. There is a plethora of them, and there's no need not to take advantage of them. They are free. They are there for you to learn and use, and is made by nurses for nurses. So some of those resources that we nurses use is nursing.com, Simple Nursing, Nurse Sarah RN. I personally like to use Wendy Riggs for anatomy and physiology because she makes concepts so easy and she's very funny. So it makes you know what she's talking about and it helps you memorize what she says so that way you can put it in your notes. However, if you are Canadian, these resources are American-based. So you have to be very careful when it comes to the values. So for instance, temperature might be in Fahrenheit. The blood glucose levels might be different, or they will be different because our glucose is, I know. It's 4 to 7. Blood glucose is 75 to 100, I believe. So things like that, you have to be careful because a conversion could definitely be different. However, what I use for my nursing school and nursing right now is the Molesby Comprehension. I use it to study for my CPNRE. And also, I use right now the Elsevier. I think that's how you pronounce it. I bought their textbook and they are Canadian based as well. And those two books are really good for Canadian nurses as well. So always look for outside resources because your textbook is just a textbook. Like, it won't give you any hints, any tips, any tricks, nothing like that. So when you go and you look for outside sources, they help you and they are more fun and it's by nurses for nurses. So you feel more comfortable and the language is not as, it's more simple for you to memorize it better, hopefully, or to know it better. Hopefully that makes sense. The purpose of doing this is to see what notes you've missed and what you could add onto your notes. And I kid you guys not, doing this method, it helps elevate your level of thinking so much. That, to me, definitely helped me pass anatomy and physiology because mnemonics, tips and tricks, and they just say funny things and do silly things that you just won't forget. And when you don't forget it, you will know it for your test. You see how it's working and how it's all coming together? So after all that is said and done, you've read your textbook, you've written your notes, you looked at outside resources, you compared notes, you wrote your mnemonics, you wrote your tips and tricks, the next thing I like to do is take a break. I take a 30-minute break of doing nothing. I don't even look at my textbook. I don't do anything that's related to anatomy and physiology. So what I do is once I come back from my break, I will go on my whiteboard and I write down every single thing from top to bottom, what I remember about that topic. And if I find myself looking back on my notes a lot, then I make, okay, I have to go back and study some more. But if I find that I'm okay and I'm writing out a lot of information and I missed one or two things, this just basically gives me a gauge of where my strengths and my weaknesses are in this topic. And I do it again the next day before I go into a different topic. So that way I know where I need to study some more and what my strengths are and what my weaknesses are. And what I like to do is after I've done splurging, I will go back to my objectives and I'll answer those questions. Those questions will help me critically think about the answer. And depending on how in-depth I answer the question, it shows me how much knowledge I have on that topic. Because again, chances are the objectives is what your test is going to be on. So if you're not able to answer those objective questions well, you are not going to be doing well on your test. So you want to make sure that you answer all your objective questions to the best of your ability. So the takeaway that I want to give you guys for studying for anatomy and physiology is it takes time. There is a lot of information to take in, okay? You are not going to know everything overnight. You are not going to know everything by studying it once. Girl, there is 206 bones in your body. There is about 600 muscles in your body. There's no way you can know every single one of those bones and muscles in a week, okay? It takes time. Also, do a little bit of a review before you move on to the next topic. That way you refresh your mind, you refresh your memory on what you studied previously before. Do this and continue to study. Don't give up. When you study and you study and you study with rest, you will do amazing in this class. And also, have fun. You are learning about your human body. That is amazing. When you make this class fun and enjoyable, you make it worthwhile. You want to do more. You want to learn more. And trust me, learning about your body is hella interesting. So So those are the takeaways that I have for you guys in this class. I hope you guys learn and take these tips that I give you guys to pass this class. Trust me, this class is hard, but it's not impossible. If it was impossible, there'll be no nurses here, okay? There'll be no doctors. So remember, this race, this class is not for the quick and for the swift, but for the slow and steady, because slow and steady always wins the race. Okay, and with that being said, thank you guys so much for tuning in to this video. If you guys watched this at the end, make sure you guys put this emoji on. If you guys watched to the end, put this emoji on so that way I know that you guys have watched it and you guys are taking in my tips and tricks. And also tag me, okay? Tag me in your notes taking because I want to see how your notes look like. So just tag me and let me know how it's going. Again, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.